Halloween is just around the corner, and I'm sorry you can no longer buy the sexy burka outfit on Amazon.com. Let's take a look at it. It was listed for £18.99 on Amazon, as reported by The Telegraph. It's a gorgeous, sexy outfit made from a lovely, soft stretch material. After people made complaints about it, such as, you know, it's not a joke, whoever you are, fear Allah. It was pulled down, according to an Amazon spokesperson. All marketplace sellers must follow our selling guidelines, and those who don't will be subject to action. This product in question is no longer available, so it's down.
Okay, so Halloween is coming, my favorite time of the year, as it, if nothing else, serves as an eternal and consistent reminder that however terrifying the ghosts and ghouls that traditionally define the festival appear to be, they are in fact a joy when compared to the living human beings who actually inhabit the Earth. Case in point, this story here, which, I mean, it doesn't get any easier than this, folks. Amazon.com have taken the cowardly decision to remove a Halloween costume from their sales platform following a short burst of idiotic whinging from the usual suspects. Because remember, everybody, the current state of the world dictates that if you don't like something, if a particular item of clothing offends you, it's not good enough to simply exercise your right not to buy it. What you have to do is prevent anybody else from buying it, and thus the tyrannical march of cultural authoritarianism continues. And yet, the Young Turks seem mightily confused by all of this, so let's see if we can help them out, shall we?
This was another story that when I'm first reading it, I'm like, I don't know if this is a liberal thing, a conservative thing, which religion thing it is. Is it liberals who are like, that's culturally insensitive? Or is it conservatives like, no, you're celebrating Islam, don't do that? Or is it conservative Muslims who are like, no, that makes fun of our religion? Or conservative Christians who are like, no, let's not celebrate their religion?
Ugh, oh my God. That's his blowjob face right there, gang. I mean, talk about frightening. The sexy yuga has now replaced the sexy burqa at Halloween stores everywhere. Instant muddying of the water right away. Just a pathetic waste of time. It could be anybody. I've read the story and I just can't tell if it's the liberals or the Christians or the Japanese stamp collectors. Well, you haven't read the story then. Because the people behind this are identified from the very first line. A sexy burqa outfit listed for sale on Amazon has been removed from the site following complaints of cultural insensitivity and racism. The Evening Standard reports that some customers had described the garment as racist before it was withdrawn from sale, with one commenting, "It's not a joke. Whoever you are, fear Allah." So it's perfectly clear that this campaign was spearheaded by fanatical SJW types, the people to whom TYT regularly pander, by the way, with the militant Muslims stepping into bat as well. Funny how often they can be found singing from the same hymn sheet, isn't it? The unholy alliance, the ongoing Molotov-Ribbentrop pact between two groups who have long since realized that the only thing they hate more than each other is liberty and Western civilization. So, not a great start by Jenk there, needless to say, but I trust things will get better from here.
And then so it turns out it's conservative Muslims.
Yeah, I think so.
I guess it's conservative Muslim. I don't understand the obsession with the burqa.
This man is an idiot, straight away. Straight away I know that. The little light's gone off. Ding! And I'm sorry, I know that's not an argument and it doesn't make him a bad person or anything. I'm just saying that based on sentence one, it would be a small miracle if what follows will contain even a shred of insight.
There's an obsession with this summer. We had the whole thing with the burqa on the beach.
Burkini.
And now it's the sexy burqa. Like, what is it about this? Like you said, it seems to bother everybody. You know, whether you're Christian or Muslim, yes, they should wear it. No, they shouldn't. Now I'm going to make a mini dress out of it. I don't get it. I don't understand the obsession.
Well, I did warn you, didn't I? I mean, what the hell was that? Excuse me, bald black Young Turk, what's your opinion on this story?
I don't get it.
Oh, thanks. Glad I asked. These people are supposed to be news commentators.
I don't understand the obsession with the burqa.
Well, I'll explain it to you, okay? I'll explain it to you. The burqa, or actually, that looks more like the niqab, but whatever, is a symbol of the Islamic oppression of women, designed to destroy their sexuality and keep them the subservient property of men. It is forced on millions of people throughout the Muslim world, and everyone else with an ounce of moral decency sees it as absurd, wicked, and the mirror image of everything we have learned about human dignity, happiness, and prosperity since the dawn of time. We think it's so ridiculous that you can even make a joke about it, mock it, and turn it into a fancy dress costume for a laugh. Morons, moral cowards, and Islamic fascists disagree. Are you caught up now? I mean, can we begin to give actual opinions and defend liberalism, please?
I think it goes beyond the burqa, right? And this whole, you know, notion of my culture is not a costume, right?
Well, the costumes within cultures are costumes.
Halloween, right? With racist costumes, right?
What?
These have been the main culprits of doing blackface.
Culprits? To jail with you.
The question is it racist? Maybe not racist, but it's culturally insensitive, right?
No, that's not right.
Right.
Right? Wrong.
Since when did we become shy about being insensitive towards bad cultures? I don't think that buying this outfit necessitates feelings of animosity. You might be buying it because you love the burqa and just want to sex it up a bit. But even if every single sale of that costume went to someone who was only interested in laughing at that particular Islamic idea, good!
I remember when people just dress up as like bacon and eggs. Like, why do you have to be me? Like, why do you have to be just like a general stereotype? Not like an actual like person. Like, you're not being Michael Jackson. You're just, I'm black, so I'm gonna wear like
a burqa? Did Michael Jackson wear the burqa? Why are we talking about this?
A wife beater and all of these like tropes of blackness, right? I think that's what's problematic, right?
Only SJWs and the alt-right talk about race when they mean culture.
So, although the bacon and eggs, the Muslims also protest.
Yeah, Jews too. But at least they're coming together on something.
Sure.
So, I don't know. Okay, so then we might have a little bit of disagreement here. I don't... Halloween is a super tough place to draw lines, right? So, to me, blackface is a fairly easy place. Okay, I drew that line. We're done with it. Okay, don't do that. That's really dumb.
Sure.
Okay. But then... Sombrero.
It's fine. It's demonstrably fine. Please don't tell me we're going to have an argument about whether the sombrero is okay. What's wrong with wearing a sombrero, for fuck's sake? They're cool hats. Especially the ones you can eat at football games.
Ooh, you brought me a nacho hat.
Thanks, Ned.
Nacho, nacho, man. I want to be a nacho man.
Now, you can't do that with a British bowler, so 1-0 to the Mexicans, I say. And yes, I happen to agree. Blacking up is a dick move, but the colour of your skin is an arbitrary characteristic. So if you paint yourself black to represent a person, what you're actually saying is that skin colour is important and makes them who they are, which is obviously ridiculous. Culture is about ideas. Culture can be celebrated and it can be criticized. And it comes down to a person's individualism. I mean, God, stop trying to take the fun out of everything and just let people express themselves for one day of the year. Jesus.
Here's the thing.
Asian outfit. You know that there's a thing. And the sex.
Oh, God, this guy's back.
On Halloween, women go sexy.
Right.
Right? Yep, no matter what costume it is, they're going to sex.
Not all.
Crazy. But when you go with the sombrero or the blackface or this or that, you know, getting punched in the mouth is like, that'll slow you down. You know what
that
I mean?
Slows
like,
you
know,
all right, I'm assuming that's a bad joke.
And some Mexican guy comes up to you and is like, bam, then you're like, I probably shouldn't wear this next year.
Oh, maybe
that's
not.
The best lesson, you know, when you wear blackface, you should have to go to a black neighborhood.
All right, I'm getting scared now.
And then when you get that ass whipping, you're like, yeah, I'm not going to do that again, you know.
And like, what?
No, not yeah. Not yeah. What do you mean yeah? You notice how a potential joke evolved into his actual argument. Beat up people who offend you. Lovely. Well, I tell you what, that's great for me, because every so often, when I'm in a major European city, I notice women wearing actual burkas strolling around the place. And as I've already explained, I find the burqa repulsive and an assault on my personal feelings. But I didn't realise that according to this guy's logic, that justifies what? Approaching said woman, tearing off her veil and slapping her around a bit? What would you think of me if I were to say that? I mean, I feel like an idiot for having to make this clear, but we've reached that point now. If somebody is wearing something that you find distasteful, that does not give you license to commit assault and battery against them. I'm sorry, but we have a word for people of the contrary opinion. We call them thugs and we call them fascists, and that's what many on the left have now become. We've got a bunch of fascists running around believing that if somebody upsets you, if they make you feel uncomfortable in any way, you have the axiomatic right to respond with violence. And where have we heard that before?
And what do we do when somebody insults our Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? The first time it happened to me, I was at George Mason University giving a speech. After the speech, one came up to me, he's not Muslim, he was an old man actually, and he knows Arabic, and he came in my face and he said, "What do you say about a 53-year-old man that has sex with a 6-year-old girl?" Whoa, when he said this, I almost passed out because I couldn't believe anybody would talk like this. I couldn't believe somebody would say something like this. I knew what he meant by what he said. I was so upset. I started taking my coat off. And I would give it to the sheikh who was with me. I said, just hold my coat. I'm going to go on this guy. And as I was taking my coat off, I looked at him. I said, "This depends on your question. If it's a rhetorical question, or if you're insulting my prophet, in which case I'm going to take you out back and beat your head off your shoulders." He said, no, it's rhetorical. I said, "In this case, it doesn't need an answer."
Simply amazing. In fact, this story started with the little metrosexual butt monkey on the right there explaining that one of the reasons the costume was pulled from the site in the first place was because of intimidation.
People made complaints about it, such as, it's not a joke, whoever you are, fear Allah. It was pulled down.
Getting punched in the mouth is like, that'll slow you down.
This guy and the Islamist both agree. Nice Halloween costume. Oh, thanks. I like it. I made it myself. You disrespected me, brah!
What is the intent on Halloween when you pick a costume? Is to get some kind of reaction, right? And if that's humor and you dress as another culture, that's problematic, right? Like,
I love these costumes because it's tough at a party to identify otherwise who's terrible.
Can you imagine the kind of parties that guy attends? Anyone interested in going? Because I'm not.
Are terrible.
Right.
This person dresses Osama bin Laden. We have other ones. These are still for sale. In Smitty's Arab costume. And then this one, adult Gali dress.
Okay, I have to admit, I have no idea why anyone would want to wear that.
I'm allowed to knock you out and...
Still illegal, unfortunately.
We also have this, here's another one, the sexy from a different religion, number 7. This is the sexy nun.
Yeah, see, that's, no, guys, look, first of all, I don't condone violence, so don't knock anybody out, okay? And Halloween's for sex, it's not for violence.
So what, just rape them? I mean, I love how even Cenk realizes that he's let the dogs a little too far off the leash there, and he's dragging them back. Yeah, TYT doesn't condone violence, guys. That's why Jimmy Dore no longer works there. Oh, wait.
What the fuck? What a fucking cowardly little bitch.
Okay.
Strong email.
Strongly worded. Yeah.
All caps.
Right, now, but... if they're allowed to be sexy nuns, why can't they be sexy burkas?
I think it's when you're dressing as someone else's culture. Like if someone was...
Oh, give me a break. It's wrong if it's somebody else's culture. Well, my culture is making Halloween costumes referencing other people's cultures. So how about that? Oh no, it's cultural appropriation. So the only people who can wear sexy nun outfits then are who exactly? Actual nuns? Because that aspect of Christianity isn't part of everybody else's culture. How about this? Can Turkish Muslims wear the sexy burqa? Because they're Muslim, you see, but they don't really like the burqa. In fact, it's actually banned in public institutions there. So,
is making fun of Islam by doing this. I think it should still be for sale for the reason I said before. Like, jerks buy these things. Do it. Mm-hmm. But also there's the sexy Jew as someone who's got Jewish heritage. That's what we get.
That's the sexy Jew?
That's all we get. We just get that one. This is where you get.
They say, I'm the sexy one.
As good as it gets.
Yeah, there isn't a conflation of like ethnicity or race and religion with...
The Jews? No conflation between religion and ethnicity with the Jews? Oh, okay.
The nun outfit, like there is with the burqa, right? So it's you're just on safer ground if you're the sexy nun, because we don't relate Catholicism with a race.
Oh, it's so weak and pathetic, I'm actually starting to come out in hives. You might associate Islam with a race, but that's because you're profoundly ignorant. I'm sorry, but Islam doesn't associate itself with a race. It claims to be universal and is actually one of the most heterogeneous religions on the planet. But the whole line of reasoning is absurd on its face. Cowboys are traditionally associated with the white race, all right? But you know what? I don't have an impulse to stop Asians dressing up as them if they want to. It's so unbelievably stupid. I don't even know why I'm responding to this person.
Yeah, it's right? A more open, like, I also went to Catholic school, and I know they taught us to, like, repress sexual desire, and it made sense that you would have this weird, kinky, like, nun thing.
Okay, I don't know how much more of this I can take. They must be drinking something to kill brain cells. It's like a round table of morons, as if King Arthur decided to replace all the knights in Camelot with an egg. And he's just sat there talking to it, because we get about as much sense from that situation. Oh, there's some sexual repression in Catholicism, is there? You're a genius. You figured that out all by yourself. And you don't think that exists in Islam at all. That doesn't explain the burqa. No, covering up women so their beauty doesn't drive a man to lust and therefore bring religious shame on his soul, that's nothing to do with sexuality. No, of course not. There's no comparison there. No. A fundamental problem with the Young Turks is they don't know anything. Have you noticed that? Just general ignorance about the world. 3 million subscribers.
Right, the whole Catholic schoolgirl outfit. That is the, like, number one stripper outfit. I've heard. I don't know.
Okay, so there is a real point in there in that, yeah, if you're in a majority Christian nation, and Christians have more power, etc., and you're making fun of the minority, well, that doesn't sit as well. So, for example, if you flip it, and you're a majority Muslim nation, and they're like, let's make fun of the Christians, right? Yeah, that doesn't play well. Then you could do the sexy burqa, but not the sexy nun. So there's a power dynamic there that is logical.
Make fun of Christians in a Muslim country? No, that doesn't really happen. Kill the Christians. That happens. Persecute the Christians. Force them to pay religious taxes. Desecrate their holy sites. And generally do everything you can to drive them out of your country. That's more in keeping with how the Muslims roll when they run a society. Believe me, Christians like Asia Bibi in Pakistan, currently facing the death penalty for blasphemy, she'd give her left foot just to be laughed at. But alas, Muslims.
Those liberal, what I consider to be liberal point of view is, I think, a little bit more understandable. And hey, let's not pick on people who don't have power, etc. But when a Muslim fundamentalist complains about the sexy burqa, that for some reason bothers me more, to be honest, because I don't have to do your religion. I can do my religion or my lack of religion. So like when they say don't draw Muhammad, no, you don't draw Muhammad. Okay, right. I'm not Muslim. I don't have to follow your rules. Okay, you don't wear the sexy burqa. We get to wear the sexy burqa all we want. You see what I'm saying?
Right, Cenk. First of all, you don't get to wear the sexy burqa. You'll frighten the horses, and the mere thought of that is starting to make me side with the people who campaigned to make it unavailable, okay? But leaving that aside, the central point he made there, minus some retarded preamble, is actually bang on the money. Your religion is your business, leave me out of it. That is the liberal point of view. And I wish he'd brought it up sooner, because I'm sure the other three are looking at him as if he's just spoken Greek or something, and they probably need many of these basic moral principles carefully explained to them over the course of 10 minutes. But credit where credit's due, well done, Cenk.
So imposing the meanings of that particular religion on what you do, right? Yeah, your behavior.
And we have the perfect example in America. I mean, you have all the evangelical Christians who have power in this country. Mm-hmm. So, like, they're always worried about Sharia law. There ain't much Sharia law here. They're always in Oklahoma, like, oh my God, Sharia law coming!
And then he had to ruin it. See what was done there? The man is compelled to bash the Christians when they have nothing to do with this story. They're nowhere to be seen. The perfect example you have there in America, Cenk, is this exact thing. It's Muslims demanding special privileges, enforcing their prehistoric religion on Americans by means of intimidation, with an army of regressives in support. I don't know what it is, but it's like every time there's a glimmer of hope, whenever Cenk says something remotely sensible, and you fool yourself into thinking, he may be coming back over to the light side. He stabs Han Solo in the chest and ruins everybody's day. It's astounding. And notice how comfortable they all got immediately when he changed the topic of conversation. Oh, Christians fearing Sharia law? I can laugh at that. I can agree with that, Cenk. Thanks for saving me from the previous point you made, because I thought I'd actually have to criticize the Muslims for a second. Glad that was avoided. Cheers, Ta. Back on message. Good night, everyone.
There's no Sharia law, right? But the evangelicals, they do want to impose their beliefs, and they're like, okay, now you have to be pro-life. No, you have to be pro-life. I can be pro-life.
And they end it there. Amazing.
TYT has been on the air for a really long time.
Oh, I know. Really long. Proof that there is a God and he's pissed at the world for some reason. Look, don't allow social justice warriors and radical Muslims to bully you on this issue. It's a Halloween costume, for fuck's sake. It's not even that important, but perhaps in this one respect. If we are going to break the spell, as Daniel Dennett puts it, that Islam has over the modern world, one of the tools we have to deploy is ridicule. We need to take insane ideas, such as the burqa, and beat the hell out of them. And mockery is an extremely powerful way of doing that. It allows you to easily highlight the absurdity of an idea, for one, and perhaps, more importantly, given the underlying horror many of these ideas actually represent, it's perhaps essential as a means of preventing ourselves from descending into a black hole of psychotic despair.
No children were abused in the making of this show. Nobody was hurt, and no Islamic cartoons were used. You know, for those of you who can't take a fucking joke around here. That's it for me. Religion's fucking finished. That's it. It's fucking over, lads. It's fucking over! You've had a couple of thousand years. You've fucked it. It's over. It's fucking over! Take your Reformation, your Vatican, your fucking Mecca, and fuck off! Wait a second. Suicide fucking bombing, there's a bright idea. Every time there's a bang, the world's a wanker short. Fucking idiots. I want to see the instructor. Right, lads, I'm only going to show you this once. Fucking pricks. The very thought of 53 fucking virgins is a nightmare. It's not a fucking present, it's not a prize, it's a punishment. Give me two fire-breathing whores. day of the week. I'm a slut man. 53 virgin, and you have to fucking talk to them. It's eternity you're talking about here. You might be stuck with 53 fucking Duran Duran fans or something. For going to hell. I'm serious about that. People, that's what they need, a good shag. A good shag. Don't drop bombs on them. A jumbo jet full of fucking whores. And a bomber full of Agatha Christie books. Tell you, another book, that's what they need. Never trust people who've only got one fucking book. You know, fucking blah, 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 blah. How did you think they were going to turn out? Blah, 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 blah. Your parents choosing your fucking marriage partner. I mean, ridiculous. Fucking stupid. That's her over there. Which one? They're all the fucking same, Dad. They're black with a wee fucking window. The bottles of Guinness. Yours is third for the left. Oh, no, she's a cracker. Oh, fucking. Get home, lift a kilt, big hairy pair of balls. What are you going to do? What are you going to fucking do?